This morning's sermon will be given a separate Facebook entry by Father Adam Edwards that is already there for you to watch after the Mass. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brother. You, my brothers and sisters, pray to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, for our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Let us pray.
By your help we beseech you, Lord our God, may we walk eagerly in that same charity with which out of
I will make with the house of Israel when those days arrive. It is the Lord who speaks. Deep within them I will plant my law, writing on their hearts. Then I will be their God, and they shall be my people. There will be no further need for neighbour to try to teach neighbour, or brother to say to brother, learn to know the Lord. No, they will since I will forgive their iniquity and never call the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Out of death, submitted so humbly that his prayer was heard. Although he was son, he learnt to obey through suffering. But he became perfect. He became for all who obey him the source of eternal salvation. The word of God. Thanks be to God.
Praise to you.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, among those who went up to the festival were some Greeks. These approached Philip, who came from Bethsaida in Galilee, and put this request to him. We should like to see Jesus. Philip went to tell Andrew, and Andrew and Philip together went to tell Jesus. But if it dies, it yields a rich price. Anyone who loves his life loses it. And anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honour him. Now my soul is and I will glorify it again. People standing by who heard this said it was a clap of thunder. Others said it was an angel speaking to him. Jesus answered, it was not for my sake that this voice came. Now sentence is being passed on this world. Now the prince of this world is to be overthrown.
On Sunday marks a turning point in our journey through Lent as we enter Passiontide. The crosses and the statues in our church are veiled as we start to prepare ourselves for Holy Week and Easter, as we set our faces towards Jerusalem to walk with Jesus to the cross and to the empty tomb. It's a time where the drama of Jesus's final few days starts to increase, the tension increases and the pace quickens as we set our faces towards Jerusalem. Today's gospel reading from John is full of action. It takes place after Jesus's entry into Jerusalem on that first Palm Sunday. Jesus has raised Lazarus from the dead. Crowds have gathered to welcome him into the city and to hear him speak. All eyes are on Jesus. The crowds, the authorities, those who want to sing Hosanna, and those who are seeking to plot his death. In today's gospel, even the Greeks have asked if they might see Jesus. And in John's gospel, that is the first interaction that Jesus has with one of the Gentiles. All has been set in place. Jesus now knows his time has come. The reason that he came into the world is reaching its fulfillment. And in John's Gospel, the cross is not a failure, it's a triumph. In John's Passion narrative that we will hear on Good Friday, those final words from Jesus, "It is accomplished. It is here that God glorifies himself." In today's Gospel, Jesus says that he is going to be lifted up from the earth, indicating the kind of death that he's going to suffer, and that he will draw all people to himself. That image of Jesus lifted up got me thinking about that scene on that first Good Friday when Jesus is lifted up on the cross. And it can seem quite a bleak scene. He's been forsaken by his followers. Judas has betrayed him. Peter has denied him. And all or most of the others have fled through fear or self-interest. This week on Thursday, we will celebrate the Feast of the Annunciation, where Gabriel greets Mary and tells her that she's going to bear a son. And those lovely words of comfort from Gabriel at the start. "Greetings, favoured one. The Lord is with you." And as we are in the midst of Passiontide looking towards Holy Week, we are reminded of the incarnation of Christmas and that wonderful title that we give Jesus, Emmanuel, which means God is with us. At the start of John's Gospel, we hear in that wonderful prologue about God becoming flesh and living among us. And throughout his life on earth, the Gospels are full of Jesus wanting to be with people. In today's Gospel, people are desperate to be with Jesus, wanting to be close to him, wanting to be a part of his story. And as we approach Holy Week, we start to see all of those people that wanted to be with him slowly drifting away and deserting him, till at that moment when Jesus is lifted up from the earth, he is left without those who cheered for him, without those who followed him, without those he had worked so hard to be with. But at that moment of utter pain and suffering, in the midst of desertion and betrayal and isolation, Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us, is with us in that most precious way, even if we are not with him. God with us, Jesus, experiences death, and God with us experiences what it is like to be without breath, without company, without consciousness, without a body. In the isolation that we have felt over the last year, in the death and the loss, in the pain and the suffering and in the fear, God has been with us and continues to be with us, because God has known and knows what it is to suffer all of these things. And so, as we approach the next 2 weeks and contemplate the passion of Jesus, God will be with us. But will we be with God? Will we leave him alone? Will we desert him? Will we betray him? Will we deny him? Or will we be with him, sharing in his journey, growing closer to him in his passion, and learning what that means for our lives? Will we grow so close to him and be with him that we will witness to the cross in our lives and be able to talk to people about what Jesus, God with us, means to us in our lives. And if we can do that through our lives and witness, through the message of Jesus Christ, crucified and risen from the dead, lived out and preached in our lives, we will bring those words of John's Gospel to fulfillment, that when Jesus is lifted up, he will indeed draw all people to himself. Amen.
Let us proclaim our faith in the words of the Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is Calvary with Christ. Pray that in these days of grace we may stay close to him. We pray for the Church, for our Bishop Jonathan. His fellow bishops may shepherd their flocks in wisdom and holiness. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us. Lord, gracious. We continue to pray for those afflicted by the COVID-19 pandemic, for all who are ill, and for let us pray to the Lord. Lord, graciously hear us. We offer to God all who are in need, and especially those who have requested our prayers. We pray by name for Tony Arthurs, Val Beckett, Norman Bowden, Amelia Butler, John Clues, Harry Coxon, Jane Eccleston, Brenda Feeney, Joe Fielder, priest, Sue Founds, Christine Gilbert, Hannah Giles, Kath Hale, Keith Henwood, Anne Hill, Lindy Humphrey, Alan Hyde, Geraldine Long, Gary Orr, Geraldine Nixon, Mary Pearson, Giles Tinsley, Jenny Tinsley, Nigel Tinsley, Eric Tomlinson, Jenny Winwood, Julie Whitehouse, Samuel Briarwood, Irene, Ray Phillips, and Bessie Pratt, whose anniversaries occur. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We commend ourselves and all for whom we have prayed to the Let us pray for a moment. Father, guide our hearts and minds as we walk with your Son. Keep us faithful to his teaching always. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
We offer you, Lord, the grace of salvation, giving thanks that you have had us work. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who are in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and with the blessed apostles and all you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus.
Through him and with him and in him.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
We pray the Almighty God, we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Before the blessing, I want to mention our plans for Holy Week. This will be simply the early part of this week. We regret that at this time it is not possible to reopen St. Martin's for divine worship. We're working to rectify that as soon as we can. It will be offered here for Palm Sunday at 9:30 and at Holy Trinity at St. Stephen's at 11:00, the normal Parish times, as it were. And details of services throughout the Easter day will be circulated and will also be found on our Facebook page. We look forward once again to welcoming worshippers back into our churches and back into the wonderful sacramental care that Jesus Christ's